isn't it? Let me explain our vision for Grand Wagoneer. It will not be simply another Jeep SUV. It comes from the same roots and experience, but it will evolve into something new, very distinctive and unique. Because the customer is different, the values are different, the essence is different. The Jeep customer loves traveling, camping, and fishing. The Wagoneer driver would rather go golfing on the finest courses or cruising on their sailboat. One seeks fun to drive and capability. The other one goes for styling and comfort. Jeep stands for freedom, adventure, and passion. Wagoneer means timeless design, authenticity, and refined sophistication. The essence of Jeep is in the extraordinary journey you make with it. If Jeep was a house, it would be a cabin in the wood. Wagoneer, a glass house on the ocean. If there were a city, Jeep would be Jackson Hole and Wagoneer, New York. If there were a road trip, Jeep would be the Rubicon Trail, Wagoneer, a beautiful snowy road in the Rockies. If it was a water activity, Jeep would be a jet ski or a kayak, Wagoneer, a custom-made boat. In our vision, Wagoneer will become a portfolio of SUVs that will redefine American premium and delivers a unique customer experience, designed to authentically personify the entrepreneurial spirit, distinction, and intelligence of our customers. That is the reason why Grand Wagoneer is coming back to life. To tell new stories and make new memories, to stand out. And when Wagoneer comes to life, it won't be just the best premium SUVs out there. It will have it all. The comfort and luxury of a premium vehicle, the seating capacity and versatility to travel in style with premium space, the towing of a pickup truck and SUV capability, the safety and coziness of a family home, and the richness of a dream loft. And all of this will be wrapped in the most elegant body you could ever imagine. And the concept you see here today has some first. Sustainable materials and fabrics all over. Onyx glass on the instrument panel. Natural raw aluminum for the central wing. Genuine heat-treated lace wood along the interior. Recyclable microfiber suede for the headliner. Thrive fiber for the carpet, which is the most environmentally conscious fiber in the world. And a premium, sustainable polyurethane material for all the seating and interior surfaces. But don't let the beauty of this concept fool you. Grand Wagoneer can pull, can climb, can tow as no others in its class. With three 4x4 systems, quadra-lift air suspension, independent front and rear suspensions, unmatched towing, powerful performance, a host of tech, safety, connectivity features, this vehicle will have it all. And this concept also has a green soul, featuring a plug-in hybrid electric powertrain system. It provides absolute and quiet open-air freedom while taking performance, 4x4 capability, fun-to-drive experience to the next level. And we added an homage to its birthplace with an American flag flanking its name and paying tributes to the brand soul and home country. Wagoneer and Grand Wagoneer will be built here in Metro Detroit inside our Warren plant, and production will start next year. Ralph Gilles, our global head of design, will now take you through the design story behind this stunning concept and provide you a hint of the future Grand Wagoneer.
Thank you, Christian. Hi, I'm excited to tell you about what's amounted to nothing short than a labor of love for us designers at FCA. we realize that we're dealing with an absolute legend here. I mean, this is something that is a bit daunting for a head of design like myself, to think about redesigning an icon that, that people love and people associate to Americana. So what you'll find on the concept car, we actually emblazon the edge. It's an Easter egg that's easy to find that says established in 1963. Yes, the car went into production until 1962, but it was a 1963 model year and was in production until 1991. So in that time, from 1991 to 2020, a lot of Wagoneer lovers kept the flame alive for us. People like Norbert here, who does an exquisite job, and then there's Wagon Master, who's done the same, restoring these vehicles. And when you look at the mission statement that Wagon Master has on their website, it sounds very similar to what we have on our website. You're creating a symbol of the American dream here. We look back at what turns people on about the vehicle, and they told us it was the simplicity of the vehicle, the kind of the long-lasting shapes, the honesty of the proportions, the shoulder line that goes undisturbed front to back, the vertical grille that kind of leans into the wind with a lot of confidence, and then the vertical B, C, and D pillars, you know. So some of those things we actually kept going forward. Back in 2013, we actually sent a group of product planners and researchers to talk to these people and understand a little bit more about the customer itself. Now, they told us it wasn't just the vehicle they liked, it's the sense of adventure and celebrating the Americana, the American dream, you know, discovering the coolest parts and the Wild West and all that, the Grand Canyon, all those adventure spots that you hear about. We look at what Jeep means to most people. A Jeep, of course, has this incredible overtone of adventure. And we look at what Wagoneer can mean, and it's the same idea, but executed in a much more artisanal way. So you look at the backpack on the right of your screen with the leather and the really bespoke instruments, the details, the metalwork, and the way the high-quality leather is stitched together. That's all about speaking to luxury, but in a very authentic way. So who is it for? Is it for the classic American family or the growing family? Is it for the couple that's kind of has everything? Or is it for eight of your best friends that want to go camping for the weekend and create an adventure? Well, the Wagoneer can do all that. In a way, it's redefining American premium with timeless, modern, and linear shapes. So here are some of the early sketches that we looked at, and the ones that appealed to all of us were the simplest ones. It's meant to be timeless. It's meant to age well with very simple lines, a simple shoulder line. Again, you see those vertical B, C, and D pillars. And then, of course, the wheel arches that present capability and really advertise the tractive capability of the vehicle. And then there's the leaning forward front end, celebrated by the LED lighting, the animated lighting that does all kinds of cool stuff when you hit the key fob. We continue that detail all over the vehicle, whether it's the chrome work on the outside or even the badging. One of the things that will be arresting the people is when they open the door. So we create an interior that would blend functionality, technology, detail, and luxury all in one. Every touch point on the vehicle is meant to exude this artisanal thing, you know, this idea of connecting back to the person who made it, right? So every time you interface with part of the Wagoneer, you're reminded that there's love behind it. There's people that love design, love detail, love celebrating fit and finish and exquisite execution. One of my favorite elements of the interior is the transmission control knob. Even the CEO got involved. We had arguments about it. We sat there saying, okay, if we're going to do something like this, we want to make sure it's special. So even without looking at it, you just touch it. You can feel the serrations on the side. And it just exudes this absolute care about quality. The second part of the story is technology integration. Now, this is probably one of the most advanced concept vehicles we've ever had. It has just about every technological feature out there today and then some. But how do we integrate it in a way that's not intimidating? We simplified it. We distilled it down. So the technology is there, but it's really still secondary. Take, for example, the passenger entertainment screen. The main purpose of the passenger screen is basically a co-pilot screen. So the driver can't see the screen, but the passenger can do navigation, swipe it over to the driver. The passenger can control what the rear occupants are seeing or watch their favorite TV show, by the way, that they were watching in their living room, pause it, and keep watching it in the car. And then the rear passengers are treated in some ways spoiled more so than even the front passengers. So every seat in the Wagoneer is a first-class experience. Every touch point in the vehicle was considered, the softness of the leather, the detailing, the perforation, the striations, everything, to create an absolute opulent experience. And top that all off with something I don't think anyone's ever done before. So creating this absolute mood. So this is one of my favorite modes of vehicle. I call it relax mode. You just park somewhere and relax, and the aurora borealis shows up. So you and your Wagoneer almost become like an escape pod. The interior does a lot of other things besides being a place of relaxation. Yes, you can watch movies on it. Yes, you can entertain yourself, but you can also control your massage seating with the lower comfort screen. All that is integrated by a very, very powerful execution of the Uconnect 5 system. Now, to top it all off, we worked with Macintosh and developed an exquisite, exquisite system. Not only does it sound great, but it's presented in a cool way. Our designers went maybe a little overboard and created a conversation piece out of the front speaker grille. It's also lit, you know, so at night you're reminded that you went the extra mile and got the Macintosh system. And then finally, the end result is an interior that I think is uniquely American, and again, reminds you of, in a way, your success, but also how much we care and want to celebrate what the Wagoneer experience is all about. And with that, let's introduce, again, the Wagoneer. So this is a vehicle that, in a way, is a long time coming for us, something I've wanted to work on my whole career as a full-size SUV. I really like the presence it has, the way the front end kind of, again, leans forward like we talked about. And the stance, which is so, so important in a vehicle like this. It looks good just standing still.
Subscribe now to UCar, a point of reference for car fans since 2010.